introduce our unpublished data with you today. Our data is about cyanidin 3-O glucoside, ameliorate lipid, and glucose accumulation in C57BL6J mice, while activation of PPAR-α and AMPK. First, I would like to introduce cyanidin 3-O glucoside. We call it C3G to you. They are natural pigments, show red to purple to blue color, and it's abundant in lots of fruits and vegetables, especially in lots of berries. The function of C3G is known as antioxidant and anti-inflammatory effects, thus reduce cardiovascular disease, cancer, obesity, and diabetes. Furthermore, our previous study already shows that the non-glucoside type of C3G, cyanidin, could reduce both triglyceride and cholesterol concentration in the hepatocyte and macrophage cells, while regulating some important protein involved in lipid metabolism, such as PPAR-α and LXR-α. Furthermore, there is some studies show that the glucoside form of cyanidin, C3G, has higher stability compared with cyanidin. However, the molecular target of C3G has not been identified. So the objective of our research is to investigate the effects and the molecular mechanism of C3G. And because already there is lots of research show that berries containing C3G could regulate lipid and glucose metabolisms. So here I would like to introduce two important proteins involved both lipid and glucose metabolism. The first one is peroxisome proliferator activated receptors, PPARs. They are nuclear receptors and containing three subtypes, alpha, gamma, and delta, or call it beta. The activation of PPARs is induced by direct binding of their ligands, and then the protein will bind with the target DNA on the specific phage named PPARE to induce the transcription of these genes. PPAR-α is a major regulator of lipid metabolism in the liver. It could regulate fatty acid uptake, utilization, and catabolism, as well as induce ketogenesis and triglyceride turnover. There are two kinds of ligands for PPAR-α, the synthetic ligands, such as some drugs, as fibrate drugs, which are used for the treatment of hyperlipidemia, and it also contains endogenous ligands, including lots of fatty acid. The second protein I would like to introduce is a kinase. The name is AMP, activated protein kinase, AMPK. It is an enzyme play a role in cellular energy homeostasis. It contains three proteins, alpha, beta, and gamma, and these three proteins together could make a functional enzyme. Activation of AMPK is induced by the increasing of the ratio between AMP to ATP, thus increase the binding of AMP with the gamma subtype of AMPK. So, induce the phosphorylation of AMPK to activate it. Activation of AMPK is known to stimulate fatty acid oxidation, ketogenesis, whereas inhibit lipogenesis, triglyceride synthesis, and gluconeogenesis. So here is our experimental design. First, we use surface protons, plasmon, resonance SPR assay, as well as the TR-FRET co-activator assay and AMPK activity assay to identify the molecular target of C3G. And then we investigate the effect and the mechanism of C3G both in hepatocytes and C57BL6J mice. In the animal experiment, we first feed the mice by high-fat diet for 4 weeks, and then feed the mice by phenofibrate as the positive control, or C3G, for another 8 weeks. And then finally, we investigate the physiological relevance and the molecular mechanisms of C3G. First, we can see the effect of C3G with PPAR-α. By the SPR assay, we can investigate the direct binding between C3G with PPAR protein. In this assay, we first immobilize the PPAR protein on a sensor chip and then inject different concentrations of C3G. If C3G bind with the PPAR protein, the light reflected from the sensor chip will be changed, so we can detect the response unit. Our results show that C3G directly bind with three subtypes of PPARs and show the strongest effect with PPAR alpha as the KD value as 456 nanomer. And then to further investigate the effect of C3G with PPAR proteins, we perform TR freight assay. In this assay, we add different concentrations of C3G in the TB labeled PPAR protein. And if C3G bind and activate PPAR protein, it will induce another I5 labeled coactivator peptide bind with the PPAR protein. So we can calculate the TR freight ratio. Here you can see C3G activate three subtypes of PPARs and show the strongest activity with PPAR alpha. We also calculated the EC50 of C3G and show that for PPAR alpha, the EC50 is about 1 micromolar. And then we also investigate the effect of C3G with AMPK. In our result, we found that C3G induces AMPK alpha 1 and alpha 2 subtype and shows stronger effect with AMPK alpha 1. And in the computation analysis, we found that, interestingly, C3G compete with the non-activator of AMPK, A769662 compound, which indicates that C3G may share the same binding position with the A compound at the beta subunit of AMPK. So now we know that C3G directly activates PPAR-α and AMPK. And at the beginning, I already tell you both PPAR-α and AMPK is involved in lipid metabolism. So next, we investigate the effect of C3G on lipid concentrations. In our result, we found that C3G reduces the intracellular triglyceride concentration in hepatocyte as well as reduce both plasma and hepatic triglyceride significantly in the mice and also reduce the lipid accumulation in the liver section. The AST and ALT concentration were also reduced by C3G, which indicate that C3G also improved the function of the liver. And then to further investigate the mechanism of C3G on lipid metabolism, we investigate the effect of C3G on fatty acid oxidation, fatty acid synthesis, and ketogenesis. Because we already know that PPAR-α is reported to directly induce genes involved in fatty acid oxidation and ketogenesis, well, activation of AMPK is known to inhibit ACC, which is an important protein involved in lipogenesis, by phosphorylation, thus reduce the formation of malonyl CoA to reduce fatty acid synthesis and in turn activate induce CPT activity to increase fatty acid oxidation. Our result shows that C3G induces fatty acid oxidation in both hepatocyte and the liver of the mice, which were measured by a carbon 14 labeled experiment. And furthermore, we also investigate the effect of C3G on fatty acid synthesis and show that C3G also reduces fatty acid synthesis in a dose-dependent manner in both hepatocyte and ex vivo experiment used the liver of the mice. And we further show that the malonyl CoA concentration was also reduced by C3G administration, whereas a ketone body was induced by C3G administration. And at last, we also investigate the genes involved in lipid metabolism containing PPAR-α as well as its responsive genes, such as CPT1 involved in fatty acid oxidation, LPL involved in triglyceride hydrolysis, and HMG GCS2, which is involved in ketogenesis. Our results show that C3G induced gene expression of PPAR-α as well as its responsive genes. So we can conclude that C3G reduces lipid accumulation while increase fatty acid oxidation ketogenesis, whereas inhibit fatty acid synthesis. And next, we investigate the effect of C3G on autophagy pathway, because nowadays it is reported that the autophagy pathway could reduce lipid accumulation while break down some undesirable lipid droplets. It is already shown that phosphorylation of AMPK could inhibit activity of mTOR by phosphorylation 8 by phosphorylated, thus in turn activate autophagy pathway. Our research shows that C3G administration induces phosphorylation of AMPK as well as mTOR, thus downregulate the phosphorylation of target gene of mTOR at 6K1, and then we investigate the effect of C3G on autophagy pathway. LC32 is a well-known Markov protein involved in autophagy pathway, and we show that C3G administration induces the protein expression of LC32 in both hepatocyte and the liver of the mice. And by the MDC staining, we also show that C3G directly induces autophagy in the hepatocytes in a dosage-dependent manner. And at last, because it is not the last stage of autophagy pathway, lysosome is the key stage to break down the undesirable lipid. So we also investigate the effect of C3G on autolysosome. And our microscope image shows that C3G administration also increased the autolysosome compared with that of in the control groups. So we can see that C3G reduced lipid accumulation also while activation of hepatic autophagy pathway. And then we investigate the effect of C3G in glucose metabolism. First, we found that C3G reduced both glucose and insulin concentrations in the plasma of the mice. It also improved glucose and insulin tolerance, thus improve the insulin sensitivity of the mice. So to investigate its mechanism, we performed the metabolic profiling to investigate the metabolites of mouse and show that the glucogenic amino acid was reduced significantly by C3G administration. So we can suggest that maybe C3G reduces gluconeogenesis to improve metabolism. So to confirm this result, we also investigate the effect of C3G on gluconeogenesis by use hepatocyte, and our results show that C3G also reduces gluconeogenesis in these cells. And then, because we already know that AMPK is reported as a key protein involved in gluconeogenesis, because the gluconeogenesis is regulated by FoxO1 and CREB, one, the coactivator of FoxO1 and CREB is HDAC5 and CRTC2 bind with these two proteins. It will induce the transcription of their responsive genes, PepsiK and G6-PASE, which are key regulators in the gluconeogenesis. However, activation of AMPK could phosphorylate CRTC2 and HDAC5, thus block the translocation of these two protein into the nuclear to block the pathway of gluconeogenesis. So we investigate the effect of C3G on this pathway. Our results show that C3G induces phosphorylation of AMPK as well as CRTC2 and HDAC5, thus reduce the activity of FoxO and CREB to reduce the mRNA expression of their responsive genes PepsiK and G6-PASE. Furthermore, we also found the plasma concentration of adiponectin was increased because adiponectin is also suggested to involve in the glucose utilization. So So we can conclude that C3G reduces glucose accumulation while inhibit the hepatic gluconeogenesis. At last, we investigate the effect of C3G on body weight. Our results show that C3G reduces body weight as well as the fat weight and also reduces the size of adipocyte. And to investigate its mechanism, we investigate the energy expenditure of these mice. And our results show that administration of C3G increases the energy expenditure of the mice compared with that of control. And furthermore, because we already know that the brown adipose tissue is one of key tissues which could regulate the thermogenesis. So we investigate the key gene expressions in the brown adipose tissue. Our results show that C3G induces the gene expression of PPAR-α as well as its co-activator, PGC1-α, and their target genes, UCP1. UCP1 is a key regulator in the thermogenesis. So we can conclude that C3G reduces reduce body weight while increase both energy expenditure and thermogenesis in brown adipose tissue. At last, we conclude that C3G activates both PPAR-α and AMPK, thus induce fatty acid oxidation, energy expenditure, autophagy pathway, and insulin sensitivity, whereas inhibit fatty acid synthesis and gluconeogenesis, thus reduce body weight, fat weight, the accumulation of lipid and glucose, improve insulin sensitivity, and at last we also investigate the effects of ALTA to show that it may also have some effect to reduce the atherosclerosis. At last, I would like to thank to my lab, especially my supervisor, Professor Song Jin Li, and Yihua Women's University, and also the Rural Development Administration of Korea. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much.
Efficient effects of cyanidin triglyceride. Your experiments about PPAR-α experiments, they were very nice, actually. My question is, do you know what's the, when it is absorbed, cyanidin triglyceride, what's the main metabolite? So that's not cyanidin triglyceride anymore. So how can you explain that? Do you think they still have activate PPAR alpha in the animal? Because you know cyanidins are not very easily absorbed. So do you know what's the major circulating metabolite of this compound?
I'm not very. And you mean?
Yes. Yes, just, I know. Your experiments about the PPAR alpha activation are very nice because you use the pure compound. But when you give this to mice, so they absorb this compound and metabolize.
So
do you know if in the circulation they still have cyanidin triglyceride or not a different compound?
Yeah. It's a very good question. And we already take the plasma sample from the mouse after treatment of cyanidin and C3G, and we send the sample to another lab to help us to analyze the plasma concentration of C3G. And we have not get the result yet. So I'm not sure how much is in.
About 3-5%
intake.
When C3G is absorbed by intestine, C3G itself can be directly uptaken by intestine, or glucoside is degraded and cyanidin or glycogen is delivered to blood. And according to the published data, our EC50 value is
it's lower than that lower concentration.
Than the final active compound will be just from the alcohol.
That's not quite true, but some oglycone concentration Glycoside and oglycone can be presented in the blood, but oglycone may be the major compound.
Yeah.
But at least oglycone concentration is higher than EC50 value. So that's one of the major questions when we submit the paper, you know, to.
Yeah.